you might be mistaken for thinking that STV Edinburgh have sent me off to some nice tropical land somewhere. Actually, the truth is, I'm in Lasswade, in a wee corner of Edinburgh where there's lots of bugs, beasties and butterflies. They're roasting. Come on, we'll go and find them.
We've got everything, invertebrates to vertebrates, animals with backbones, animals without backbones, big snakes, 16-foot Burmese python, little chameleons, all the way to terrapins behind us.
Tell me, Keith, how many species of butterflies do you have in here?
20-odd, at least 20-odd different types of butterfly.
And how do they survive and what purpose do they have in the ecosystem? Because they look very beautiful, they're flying about, they look very gracious. Do they play an important part in life?
Really important. Pollination of plants is the key. Other than bees and wasps, butterflies are up there. Lepidoptera, the family butterflies, they're really important.
So talk me through the colours and the camouflage. What does that represent and why does that help them survive?
Usually the outside of the wings, when the wings are closed, are camouflaged. What tends to happen with the butterflies is we've got a blue morpho that's brown, really boring on the outside. When he opens up his wings, he's iridescent blue, bright blue. And that's to try and scare away predators. They'll flash the blue at you to try and scare away predators. We've got an owl butterfly that's got a snake's head as well as an owl's eye on the wing. Snake's head, owl's eye and a lizard's ear. So that's three predators. Of the predators of a butterfly on a butterfly's wing.
Isn't nature just absolutely fantastic that on such a dainty, delicate, fragile insect, there's the picture of an owl's eye and a snake's head?
It's amazing. The kids love it.
So we're in the reptile room now. I'm with Joni. Tell me about her.
Joni's an African royal python, a custom seizure. When she was a baby, she was found in a suitcase in an airport.
What if she decided she wanted to squeeze me?
You're bigger than a guinea pig, so she won't squeeze anything that she can't eat.
Okay. Tell me who else you have in here as well.
In the reptile room, there's Fluffy, the big Burmese python, the albino Burmese python, about maybe 14 foot long.
I see some eight-legged friends that are rather hairy behind us. I can't even look at them. Do you help people who maybe are scared of spiders?
We do phobia lessons. The assistant manager here, Kevin, is really good at curing phobias.
I'm not touching a tarantula. So they're waiting to find a tarantula for us, and I am completely not holding a tarantula. So camera lady Fee is going to hold the tarantula. I'll stick with the butterflies and the snakes.
See, the one thing you notice is I'm no nervous, but I've got an unsteady hand too. And if you're nervous, your hands will be shaking a wee bit. But she's fine, honest. Are you all right?
Oh, what is it? Is it the spiders?
Oh, no, I was just closing it.
Look at the rouge one. Look at the one stuck to the window.
No,
look at it.
It's like, oh, my God. I'm totally freaking out.